Dr. Patil Sunilkumar S, Professor and Head Civil Engineering Department, Walchand State Technology, Solapur. So I am going to discuss about analysis and design of multi-span RCC continuous beam. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the viewers will be able to explain the steps of analysis and design for a multi-span RCC continuous beam. First step. So one has to assume a cross section of the beam. So effective depth D is taken as 1/15 to 1/20th of span, where span is center to center distance between the columns. Overall depth D is equal to effective depth plus half the diameter of the bar plus clear cover, that will give us overall depth. And width of beam B, that is minimum, is 200 mm, or it can be in the multiple of, or it may be 230, 250, or in the multiple of 50 mm further. Step 2. Determination of design moment mu and design shear force vu. So for this we have to find out what is the total dead load. It consists of self weight of the beam, that is width into depth of the overall depth of the beam into density of concrete, and dead load from slab, usually it is given in the example, and dead load of floor finish we have to assume. If it is given, it's all right, otherwise you can assume what is the dead load of floor finish depending upon flooring type. So live load, usually it is given in the example. Then we have to refer the bending moment coefficients as per IS 456-2000. If you see the coefficients here, so we are having first column dead load and live load, and this is for span moments and this is for support moments. So when we want to find out the mu and vu, we are supposed to find out the highest bending moment. So if you see the coefficients here, for span moments it is lesser, denominator is more, so therefore coefficient is less. And for support moment, this is having lesser denominator, therefore this will give us, that is support moment at support next to the end support will give us the maximum bending moment. So therefore we have used the maximum support moment at the support next to end support. It is hogging bending moment, it is over the support. Mu is 1.5 times AWD into L square upon 10 plus 1.5 times WL into L square upon 9. So this 1.5 is to convert M into MU. So the maximum span moment at the near of the middle span, that is the highest of span moment we have taken. So because this is sagging in nature, this is sagging and above one is hogging. So therefore MU for sagging, it will be WD 1.5 into WD into L square upon 12, 1.5 into WL into L square upon 10. So next, the shear coefficients as per IS 456-2000. If you see the table, the first column it gives dead load and live load, and if you see the coefficients, so this is the highest coefficient, 0.6 for WD and 0.6 for WL. So to find out the highest shear force, so the highest shear force is at the outer side at the support next to the end support, that will give us the highest shear force, and for design we require highest shear force. So therefore we can calculate what is the shear force here. So the maximum shear force by using table number 13 of IS 456-2000, it is at the support next to end support, it is 1.5 times, this is 1.5, it is for conversion of shear force into VU, that is the ultimate value. So WD into 0.6 plus 1.5 into WL into 0.6 into L. So this will give us the maximum shear force. So design of continuous beam for bending moment at critical sections. Now first we have determined bending moment, now we have to design for bending moment at critical section. So depending upon the grade of steel used, the MU limit is given by following equations. So it is 0.148 FCK BD square if it is Fe250, that is mild steel. It is MU limit is equal to 0.138 FCK BD square if Fe used, steel used is Fe415. If MU limit is equal to 0.133 FCK BD square if the steel used is Fe500, where FCK is characteristic strength and MU limit is the limiting moment of resistance of the section without compression reinforcement, that is for a singly reinforced section. The maximum moment MU is usually hogging, and it is compared with MU limit. If MU is less than MU limit, it is under reinforced section. It can be designed as singly reinforced section. So find area of steel by equation G.1.1b of IS 456-2000, that is emulimit is equal to 0.87 FYSTD into 1 minus EST FY upon BDFCK. So in this equation, mu is already known. So therefore, EST you have to determine, remaining all values are given in the example. If mu is greater than mu limit, it is over-reinforced section. IS doesn't allow the design of over-reinforced section because of brittle failures, sudden failures. So hence it is to be designed as a doubly reinforced section. So therefore, using equilibrium equation of a singly reinforced section, find the tensile steel required for singly reinforced section. That is, EST1 is the steel required for singly reinforced section. So 0.87 FY EST1 into D minus 0.42 XU limit. So that is equated with the XU limit of a singly reinforced section, which is already determined. So therefore, so we have to take XU limit. This is depth of neutral axis. Limiting value of depth of neutral axis. It is 0.53D for Fe250 and 0.48D for Fe415 and 0.46D for Fe500. Equating moment of resistance offered by the forces in the compression steel with additional tensile steel AST2, we get the following equation: 0.87 FY AST into D minus D dash. So 0.87 FY into AST2, this is the force taken by compression steel, D minus D dash, this is lever arm, is equal to mu minus mu limit. This is mu limit of a singly reinforced section. Find AST2, the total tensile steel required, it is AST1 plus AST2. The strain in the compression steel is given by epsilon SC is equal to XU limit minus D dash divided by XU limit into 0.0035. This is from the strain diagram. So find force in steel in compression zone by referring figure 23 of IS 456-2000. And equating compressive stress in steel to the tensile force in additional steel which we have provided, we get FSC into ASC is equal to 0.87 FY into ST2. Find ASC. ASC is area of compression steel, steel in compression required. Determine the steel. Determination of steel is to be carried out for maximum hogging moment, which is over the support, as well as for maximum sagging moment, which is at mid-span, separately, and sectional details near support and at mid-span are shown in the figure below. So this is the sectional detail near the support wherein we get hogging moment, therefore we get more steel at top, and for sagging moment, minimum 50% of the steel should go up to end, therefore we are having less number of bars. So next, sectional details at mid-span, wherein we have sagging moment with that is at bottom, so bending tension at bottom, therefore more steel at bottom, and top we are having only hanger bars. Then design of shear reinforcement. So we have to find if shear stress, nominal shear stress, tau v is equal to vu upon bd. So vu is already determined, b is known, d is known, therefore find percentage steel. We have already provided steel for bending, therefore we have to find out what is percentage steel provided. Using table number 19 of IS 456-2000, find tau c. Tau c is the stress that can be taken by concrete alone for percentage steel provided over there. So vus is equal to vu minus tau c bd, where vus is the shear to be taken by stirrups, and tau v is the nominal shear stress, and tau c is the design shear strength of concrete. Find the spacing of the stirrups. SV is equal to 0.87 FY ASV D divided by US, where ASV is the area of stirrups. So the last one is check for deflection. So L by D max is equal to L by D max given in the table of IS 456-23.2.1 as of IS 456-2000 and into F1 into F2 into F3. So F1 from figure number 4 of IS 456-2000, F2 from figure number 5 of IS 456-2000, and F3 from figure number 6 of IS 456-2000. Here L by D provided should be less than L by D max. Now here you will find this is the figure number 4 wherein from this figure number 4 we are supposed to find out F1, and from figure number 5 we have to find out here percentage compression steel. We know it already, therefore we can find out modification factor for compression steel if it is provided. Then this is, if it is a T section, if you are designing the beam as a T section, in that particular case here you will get this particular constant also. So therefore, we are supposed to use the constant F1, F2, F3 from these three graphs given in IS 456-2000. So by using the constants F1, F2, F3, we can calculate L by Dmax. So L by Dmax provided should be less than L by Dmax as we have calculated from this particular equation. So these are the references used for this particular preparation of OER video. Thank you one and all.